Hey, this is Dr. Carlo Oger, emergency physician and founder of DrER.tv. Now, while you're sitting there just waiting, go ahead and click that subscribe button.
Awesome. Thank you.
So I'm sure I'm going to get heat from everybody for doing this video while driving, but I promise the camera is stuck to the glass here. It's on the GoPro. I have my two hands on the wheel. I'm not going to look at the camera. I just want to tell you things that are fresh in my mind so I don't forget. And you guys can enjoy and learn from it. This is kind of like a really weird thing. This is the last patient I saw today. So he comes in, it's a middle-aged man because he can't pee. And he says he hasn't peed for 3 days, which is kind of weird because his bladder's not distended, his abdomen is not distended, his blood work is normal. So if he really truly can't pee, that would cause urinary obstruction, that would cause elevated BUN and creatinine, which are the kidney labs would be abnormal, and they weren't. He had a CAT scan last when he was in the ER end of last month, and the CAT scan showed a foreign body in the bladder and some kidney stones, but the kidney stones weren't passing, so that's not really what was causing the pain. So I went to ask him about that foreign body. I said, maybe it's a big bladder stone, maybe some stone that's forming the bladders there. You know, from time to time it wiggles around, moves, and then it causes the obstruction of your urinary flow, and then you can't pee. Maybe that's all it is. And this is where the story gets really interesting. He says that years ago, like maybe a year or two ago, he was drugged up. He was having intercourse with this lady, and she introduced, and I can't believe this, a pearl necklace. So when he said that, I said, oh, you mean like in your bottom, in your rectum? He's like, no. I said, what, in your pee hole? And he's like, yeah. I'm like, says, well, that's, but did she pull it out? And he said, yeah, but I'm wondering if whatever was there, kind of like the heart, I don't know, something was left in there. It's created this calcification around it, or maybe it was just calcified to begin with. So this thing's been there for maybe a year. A piece of a pearl necklace in your bladder. How crazy is that? Anyway, I want to be, what do you call it, empathy? I want to have empathy, but I don't. I'm like, that's crazy. It's your own fault. You did this yourself. So I said, well, you need a urologist. Of course, he has no insurance to follow up with. Our hospital is smaller. It's a community-based hospital. And we don't have urologists on call. I can't even arrange a follow-up with him. So basically, his urine looked kind of cloudy. We treat him with antibiotics. We give him something for bladder spasms. We left the catheter in. We should put a Foley catheter in to get him, and he felt some relief. But he needs a urologist, so I give him the names of the local urologist he needs to call. He needs to set up his own appointment. But that's all I can do. I mean, that thing needs to come out. He needs a cystoscopy. He needs somebody to go in, get this thing out, and then he'll feel better. Until then, it's just going to keep bothering him. But how could somebody put something like that in his bladder? I mean, it's urinary pee hole. I mean, a pearl necklace? Oh, my gosh. Anyway, I thought you'd enjoy the story, so definitely comment on this and let me know what you think, if you heard any kind of weird stories like that or what that's all about, because I can't think that that's remotely pleasurable. So why do people do that kind of stuff? Anyway, all right, I'm driving now, so bye-bye.
Hey guys, thanks for watching this video. Now go ahead and go to DrER.tv.